The equity markets do look a little challenging if you have a short-term perspective. The factors for which are fairly well known. We are facing pressure, you know, of the cycle actually slowing down in terms of business cycle slowing down. We have seen the rupee depreciate by over 20% in 1 month's time, which will have its impact in terms of inflation and on liquidity. But on the positive side, we've had a very good monsoon, which should boost growth in the second half of the year currently. The real challenge will be for the next financial year is that if we do not have a strong political voice post the election, then the growth could be a little lower than what people are expecting today. This trend is mainly based on the challenges being faced by these markets you know, across the world, whether it is Brazil, India, Turkey, Indonesia. The same challenges are being faced by most of these economies, as a result of which investors are fleeing or moving out of these economies and shifting towards the developed markets. In 2013, for the first time, the growth from the developed growth from the developed countries will be actually higher than that of the emerging markets, which is a big factor which has not been there for the last 7 years. This has resulted in a lot of funds actually reducing their exposure to these markets and moving back into markets like US and Europe and Japan. Till these challenges are not faced and the resolution of these challenges is not seen by investors, the flow will remain in the same direction. The policy measures announced by the government are a good measure of the intent that they have shown for the kind of crisis that we are currently facing. However, for them to fructify on the ground will require a push forward, which has been lacking in the past. It also reflects that the government is cognizant of the key challenges that we are facing currently as a country, and that is the first step towards the resolution of those challenges. For them to show up in numbers in terms of corporate performance will take time, and investors should not expect this to translate into actually better performance of companies in the near term. Going by the business cycle in which we are currently, we are seeing a marked slowdown across most of the sectors, even sectors which are focused there on actually domestic consumption are also seeing a slowdown from the kind of robustness that we saw in 2012 and 11. However, some sectors have seen this slowdown for a far longer period as compared to other sectors. For example, commercial vehicles is one sector where we have seen a drop now for 17 months in a row, whereas in the previous cycle downturn, that drop was only for 15 months period. Similarly, in terms of telecom, we are seeing that there is a fair bit of consolidation. There is a bottoming out in terms of government regulation as such, which should be a positive for the sector. In terms of consumer goods, staples and discretionary, the slowdown is of a far shorter duration. After seeing the robustness of 2012 and 11, there has been some bit of slowdown there. However, because of a strong monsoon, this slowdown might not be too deep, you know, in these sectors, and we could see some revival there in the coming quarters for this sector as well. In the short term, the fixed income markets are well placed as compared to equity. Investors could benefit from the current interest rates, which are at a fairly high level, attractive level, to lock in some of their investment for a shorter time frame. However, post-elections, if there is a strong political mandate, then equities could easily go and improve their performance versus fixed income.
Mutual fund investments are subject to market risks. Read all scheme-related documents carefully.